Hey everybody, I'm down in Astoria, Oregon, in front of one of the coolest shops you can ever go to if you're into fishing and boating and all that sort of thing. Englund Marine here in Astoria will just blow you away. So we're gonna go in. I know Mark's in there. Mark's like one of the, he's Mark. He's just Mark from Englund Marine. Everybody knows Mark. But he's gonna take us on a tour of the retail store here, and then also the big warehouse on the side here, which is really impressive. So if you're into fishing and boating at all, you want to check this out. Okay, so here's Mark, who's a fixture here at Englund Marine, and he's gonna give us a little tour of this. And like I was saying, this is one of the coolest shops I've ever seen. I love the way you have it set up. So kind of like, just take a look here.
The Englund set this up. You come through our front door and you hit the tackle department on the left, and it comes around and goes through all the tackle and crab gear, and you go into clothing and marine hardware. We have a huge rope rack. We have a lot more rope out and back, marine seats, marine fuel filters, fuel supplies, electrical, bilge pumps, anything you need to fix your boat, the fiberglass. You come to the fiberglass table. There's everything you need to fiberglass or paint your boat. Then you come over to our paint section, and then we kind of transition over into the hardware section. So you've got marine hardware, some logging hardware, blocks for boats and logging and whatever you want to do. And then it goes into nuts, bolts, and screws. We probably have the widest selection of stainless steel anywhere, and at great prices it's for stainless. Then it goes over into grade 8 and goes into more of our industrial side stuff. So you got grade 8 bolts, grade 5 bolts, metric bolts, then into brass pipe fittings, stainless pipe fittings, then around the room into hoses and so forth, and then a huge industrial area where you can get any kind of tool, welding supplies. We have welding gas out back. You've got hammers, drills, cutters, slicers, anything you need on the industrial side, to a huge amount of abrasives, sandpaper, grinding wheels, anything like that. And then if you go around the store, that's the way it's laid out, and it makes it easy to shop. The aisles are wide, and it was set up awesomely to do that.
Yeah, this is like, this to me, this is like the perfect building. I love this building.
Kurt and John Englund designed the building. Family-owned operation for 77 years now, and it is an awesome building. Great place to work.
Yeah. So, and people around here are just lucky to have something like this here, because up around Portland or even Seattle, there's some shops where you can get similar things, but nothing to this extent.
Nothing that does as wide a range.
Right.
You've got other shops in Portland and every place else. We get a huge amount of influx, not only on the telephones, but people that just drive down the coast for the weekend and make a point of coming down to Englund Marine just to go shopping.
Yeah,
and it's a great deal.
Yeah. So let's go down the floor and just walk around a little bit. You can take a little closer look at exactly what's
absolutely
down here. Plus a tackle too. You got a really good tackle selection.
We do.
And you do all the buying, right?
I do the buying for the tackle department.
Yeah. What that means is, when he kind of has a lot to do to decide with what tackle is actually available here. And when you have somebody like Mark, who's local and is a fisherman and understands what people around here want, you're going to have stuff here that is useful here. We've all gone into shops, bigger shops, where maybe they have tackle that doesn't make sense for the area. It's because their buyers are not local like this. So
exactly, and unlike most places, all of our buyers, myself included, work on the floor every day. My desk is right out there in the tackle department, so I'm helping customers and trying to get a feel for what we need, what changes are needing. Fishing has changed a lot. 10 years ago when I started, I wouldn't have known a twitching jig, what it was or how it worked, or why would anybody even throw it in the water for silver? And now we sell tons of twitching jigs. And so if you're on the floor and working with your customers, you kind of get an idea of what you do need to buy.
Yeah, right on. Okay, let's go check it out. When I come in here, I always see a lot of things that I did, it's like, oh yeah, I want that. And but you don't see them in a lot of places, like these crab pots right here. This is definitely something that I want to buy, but that's what's great about this shop is you're always constantly seeing things that it's like, yeah, I could really use that.
And we try to switch it up really for the good seasons. Obviously, we're doing this in late November, 1st of December, and sport crabbing has been phenomenal. So you walk through the door and we've got crab cookers, crab pots, crab cooking pots, crab burners, crab pots. Every accessory you could possibly need for crabbing, a lot of stuff that is not available in other places, bait bags, commercial bait cans, Everything you need to go crabbing. Lines are looking a little light, but we got crab lines. They're all pre-made and in 50, 75, 100 foot lines. Take a tour around the store. All the floats, crab rings, crab hawks, amazing little thing to fish off the bank for crabs. Steelhead's coming up, so we switch our end caps out for steelhead. Another steelhead wall back here. This aisle is generally all salmon, flashers, pro trolls, divers, anything you need to go fish for salmon in the ocean. Diver and lead wise. Next aisle is mostly salmon lures, spinners. Of course, we 3.5s are the thing now. It used to be that that whole wall would be nothing but, you know, number six and number seven cascade blades, but now it's all 3.5s and pro trolls. Terminal tackle, you got 16 feet of hooks, actually probably closer to 20 some feet of hooks, swivels, all your terminal tackle, rods, reels, nets, the ever popular blowout table, the stuff I bought wrong, and bait back there. Scotty downriggers, Scotty rod holders, all huge stuff. Tuna aisle's looking a little bleak right now. We'll get that reloaded shortly, but that is all tuna gear along the wall there for commercial and sport use. Tuna plugs against the back wall. Bottom fish gear. Hoochies for salmon fishing, again, commercial and sport. Finally got some little pink ones back in.
Yeah.
Hard to find.
So, yeah, you know, that's the thing. Some things are really hard to get these days, but you've done a good job of keeping this stocked up.
We're trying.
Yeah.
And gaff hooks, then you come around into our clothing area. Clothing obviously has expanded hugely. When I started at Englund Marine, you had Grunin's gear, a little bit of fleece. Now Grunin's has expanded into huge stuff, guy cotton, just great clothing for being outdoors. There's some sporty stuff that you could wear to church on Sunday, but most of it is just good heavy duty outdoor clothing, sweatshirts, life jackets on the back for inflatables, extra tough boots. We stock more extra tough boots between us and Seattle Marine. Buy the biggest lot of extra tough boots anywhere. They are hard to get. Commercial boots we're well stocked in right now. I don't even know what to call them. The sportier boots, the little low top stuff that kids wear to school and everything are hard to get. We stock a full line of electronics, Lowrance, Garmin, Simrad, VHFs, VHF antennas, radars, anything you need from your biggest commercial boat down to your smallest run around the lake boat. We've got good electronics for that. Randy's our electronics guy. He does a good job with that.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Lights, any kind of nav lights you need for your boat. Obviously the ones on the left here, there's a lot of large boats for like crabbers right now. We're selling a lot of sodiums and halide lights for big view. And now we've got LEDs that come close, not quite a sodium or a halide, but close. And great deck lights, radios, safety gear, flares and all the important stuff on the left there, to horns, compasses, and then motor supplies over here for your outboard kicker motor. Huge selection of knives at Englund Marine. Dexter, Russell, Forchner, whole wall full of knives for fillet knives, boning knives, anything you need kind of knife, bubble blades, sharpening tools, some barbecue and smoking supplies along there. Just recently put in Big Chief, doing a great job with that. Gloves for commercial fishing. Todd's doing some inventory here, getting gloves stocked up. Gloves for commercial fishing, sport fishing, sportier gloves over there, dry gloves, any kind of fish handling glove you need. Obviously a basket full of these because that's what the crabbers use right now, and commercial crabbing's going on. So well stocked on those for now. Marine heads. We have just a couple of marine heads down there. We also stock all the parts and pieces for Jabsco heads. Hard to find stuff most places. We stock it all. And then it goes through a little RV section, and then your mooring lines pre-tied. Supply of anchors, bumpers, huge rope rack at Englund Marine. We have tons of rope out here. We have way more in the back. If you're looking for any kind of rope for anything decorative, vanilla rope, anything like that, we have that. Special anchor lines, lots of specialty lines, arborist lines that you can't get everywhere. Duralon, double braid Dacron, just your regular polys and nylons. Something fairly unique at Englund Marine. So we stock a full line of cable, stainless, and galvanized. If you're putting rails around a deck, rails around your boat, we have all the supplies to do that. Crimpers and tools and guys out back can show you how to put swedge in your turnbuckles and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, if you have a really pretty deck, you want to put stainless rail around and use cable for it, you can do that. We have it all here. Seats. We have a pretty good supply of marine seats now. They've been very hard to get. So the shelf looks really good, but it's a little hard to come up with. Trailer supplies all along the left, tongue jacks, winches, lights. Along the other side is all fuel supplies, fuel filters, greases, lower unit grease, bearing buddies, and we finally got ours back. Then you go into boat electrical. All the wire we sell here is tinned wire for boats. It's less corrosive than just plain copper. The tin on it makes it less corrosive. And a full line of marine grade ends, butt connectors, whatever you need, switches, terminal blocks, pretty much anything you need to wire your boat, you can probably find in that section right there.
Yeah, that's worth the trip down to a place like this just right there, because you go into a regular hardware store and buy stuff that you think is going to work on a boat trailer.
It works for a while,
but it's well worth the extra time and a little bit of money to get the marine grade stuff if you're doing electrical work.
Absolutely. Deck plates, and we get into bilge pumps, washdown pumps, freshwater supply pumps, blowers, for your big boats, all the Jabsco pumps that are down there at the end, those brass ones that nobody really knows what they do in most cases, on commercial boats or the front of your Chevy engine on your inboard. Not only do we sell the pumps, we have all the parts and pieces go inside if you need impellers, anything like that. Big boat water strainers. Obviously, we have cleats from little bitty ones you might hang on the wall in your house to hang something up on, to full-size deck and boat cleats, U-bolts, huge line of stainless hardware down there, shackles, eye-bolts, turnbuckles, all really neat stuff. Stainless steel piano hinge. Then we get over here into fiberglass, marine grade goop of every sort, size, Sikaflex, silicone, M1 has been huge, 5200, all boat grade, water grade caulkings and glues, and small toothpaste tubes if you're doing a small job. Then down into fiberglass, that's a small amount of our fiberglass stuff. We also stock 5 gallon and 55 gallon drums of fiberglass, West Systems epoxy, multiple other epoxies. For your smaller jobs, we sell bulk fiberglass that we just roll off the table and take down there. Scoop guard's super popular. Most places you can just buy a little piece. You can buy as many yards of that as you want in a row. Reflective tape for buoys. And then across the aisle, we've got marine paint. So there's lots of paints out there. These are all marine quality paints. Amaron is a huge paint for inside, outside, bottom of the boat. They do a great job. Been a little hard to get lately, so our shelves are a little low. Petit Ease Epoxy or Right Side Polyurethane from Interlux. Both great topside paints. If you're doing a shelf in your garage or a cupboard in your garage or your house, that stuff's way tougher than any regular paint. It's way more expensive, but it'll last a long time. It'll look great. It's self-leveling. Works awesome. And for the season, we got generators out here. We import our own line of coolers. Okay. All roto molded, huge quality. unlike some of the other coolers on the market, the walls aren't 4 inches thick, so there's room to actually put fish and stuff in here. We wanted a really quality fish box that would stand up to whatever. These have stood the test for, like, we've been doing this for 7 years now. They are awesome coolers.
Okay. So what, 524 for a
125 liter box.
Okay.
And and they go all the way down to 28.
Yeah, okay. That, yeah, for these types of coolers, that's not a bad price. Really.
It's really not. I mean, if you compare it to other stuff and the fact that some of the other coolers are so thick, you really can't get anything in them. These things will go 5 to 7 days without losing any ice, hardly. I'm going to spin around the corner. Shackle hardware, D-shackles, commercial boat shackles. We have Campbell graded and rated shackles, and we have a lot of import shackles that are much less expensive. You don't see blocks like that anywhere. We actually, those snatch blocks down there, if you're pulling an elk out of the woods or pulling firewood up, those are a good inexpensive block that it's a snatch block, so the top opens up so you can lay your cord or your line or your cable through there, and pretty neat deal. And then every kind of hook or anything you can put on a chain or a cable. Obviously paint supplies, sandpaper, Tyvek suits, anything you can think of there. This is our cleaners and wax section. Englund Marine, for as many years as I've been with them, does their own cleaner degreaser, easy bright. I mean, you've got to clean a bad bilge out. That cleaner degreaser is the most amazing stuff. It's all biodegradable, environmentally friendly. Easy bright's obviously acid. They've done for boats for years for etching of aluminum, whatever. And then the Fulmer line of Meguiar's, Tune Bright for polishing the boat afterwards. It's all the hard work stuff.
Yeah.
Supply of metal, if you're needing to put something together on your boat, we've got that. Then you get into the funner stuff. Forgot zinc. Englund Marine probably stocks more zinc than anybody in the Northwest, probably. I have no idea. But and this is the sporty stuff that goes on your, we have out back big zincs like this stuff up here that you can weld on big boats, aluminum weld-ons, divers dreams, teardrop anodes, and then anything that goes on your outdriver outboard. Like we mentioned before, we have a huge supply of stainless hardware.
Yeah, this is very impressive right here.
Goes through everything from tapping screws, machine bolts, carriage bolts, nuts, washers, everything goes, pretty much everything goes up to 1 inch in the machine bolts. I think we go up to 3/8 in machine screws, but cap nuts, wing nuts, finish washers, all great stainless stuff. You're putting something together on a boat or just don't want to see any rust, it's the way to go. Then we go over into grade 5, grade 8 bolts for boats, a huge amount of galvanized hardware. Sometimes stainless just isn't quite tough enough, but galvanized holds up good. And that also goes up to at least 1 inch, maybe a little bigger. Supply of metric, stainless and regular. We just put in a larger section of metric bolts. So for your boat, marine gear, or just for decorative stuff, we stock a huge amount of brass pipe supplies. Brass, stainless, water strainers, black iron. I mean, you can use black iron for anything. I've got these things, use one. All my wife's cast iron pots and pans in the house off and built a nice little rack out of it. All galvanized hardware all the way down. Hose clamps, the inexpensive tread type models. Got the ABA clamps, which are completely smooth inside. Don't cut into your hose with a little tread like these do. Definitely worth the extra money if it's someplace you don't want to have to get too often. All smooth inside. And then for the really tough stuff, you get way more pressure out of a T-bolt clamp, but you don't have a huge amount of adjustment on a T-bolt clamp. But they are the toughest, strongest. copper tubing for fuel lines or whatever you might have. We stock all the copper tubing. All the fittings are right around the corner there. These are all pressure washer heads and fittings, silver solder, soldering guns, torches. This is kind of new, flexible hose. We can build your water hoses, air hoses, whatever out of that. Come in, pick out your parts, pop them together, really quick and easy. Now we're getting to the industrial side. We have air compressors, pressure washers, axes, mauls, PVs, handles for whatever you've got. A full line of everything from Zerks for your pickup or your tractor, Never Seas, Marine and otherwise, cleaners, penetrating oils, all that kind of stuff. Mike is the tool guy, and we have a full selection of tools. We start off with performance tools that are economic, Stanley, go into all kinds of different pliers over here. Big SK dealer, if you want your lifetime warranty, however you break it, we'll fix it, type of tool, a gear wrench, full line of Makita, Bosch tools, Milwaukee, all US made Milwaukee. Safety glasses, this whole thing right here is 90% drill bits of every sort, size, color, whatever you need to do. Helicoil kits. Full wall of Bosch bits, blades, cutters, 18 volt, 36 volt tools. This is all welding supplies that I basically know nothing about. Then you've got abrasives. You gotta cut it, grind it, take it apart, put it back together. Something on this aisle will cut through it or polish it. Flapper discs, ton of stuff. I use a lot of it. There's a ton of it here, I don't.
Yeah. How are you doing, George?
This is saw blades, grinders. Hey, George.
Hey.
This is very, very impressive.
Aisle of tarps.
So,
And then this is all oil absorbents. So, you know, important in the bilge, important when you're dealing with your boat, if you spill some oil. These are all oil absorbs. Really, there's not a huge amount of difference when it goes up in price, but the more you spend, like the gray ones down there, if you've got water and oil, and the oil's floating on top, will only absorb the oil off the top, won't absorb the water. The cheaper ones will absorb everything they can get a hold of, but they're a little messier. So the more you spend on an oil absorb, the probably the better, happier you're gonna be with the whole idea.
Okay.
Charts. Oops. This actually got some in it. Marine charts, probably the only place around that still sells marine charts.
Yeah.
Most of them are on your GPS, but
those are awesome.
They're beautiful. They're water resistant.
Port of Portland, Willamette River.
Right? Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, they go all the, we go all the way from the mouth up to Bonneville Dam with charts.
Yeah.
And Willapa all the way down to Tillamook.
Okay.
But yeah, we made it back to the beginning.
Right.
The books. Right. New Camco portable refrigerators.
Oh yeah.
Pretty neat deal.
That's good, cool.
You know, I mean, this is blow you away. You come in here and it's amazing. But you know what's really amazing? Is what's on the other side of that wall right over there.
Can we go back in the
warehouse? I mean, you want to see some stuff? We're going to go see some stuff right now.
What's next to the clam ties?
Okay.
Welcome. Today, yesterday, opened yesterday. So, Englund Marine has a huge warehouse. We supply 7 of our stores. This is all tackle from back here. Just aisles and aisles of it. Boots, like I said, we stock more extra tough boots and Grendon boots, anybody, these are what we sell off the shelves, but this is all back stock, all the way to the ceiling most of the time. They've been a little hard to get. Stuff's coming in, the place is a mess, but Grendon's coming in. This is all Grendon's down to the first cross aisle there. Grendon's, muck boots. Cody's back here trying to dig a hole in clam gear. We got a ton of clam gear in. Mostly this would be all the ceiling boots. These are boots that still need to be put away. Stuff's coming in like crazy. Obviously, we got the clam hot clam guns finally came in. These are all acids and etchings and kind of not safe stuff, but stuff you need for boats. And then all the way to the ceiling. I mean, there's Kuma kill bags all over the place. Spencer's counting something. EPIRB safety gear for your boat, so emergency positioning beacons, oil, stuff we don't have about back. The right side of this is all fuel filters that are exceptionally hard to get right now. We do have some. Again, oil for your boat. These aisles are all marine paint and buoy paint. Commercial crabbers have to use a special paint on their float so they can see them. That is available to the public also. This is something you just don't find other places. These are all marine heads, marine head parts, steering parts, Jabsco pump parts. If you've got a big boat and know what I'm talking about, it's hard to find stuff. And we don't keep it out on the floor because it's a lot of little parts and pieces, but we do stock it and are very popular for it. And then it goes down into the back stock of washdown pumps, macerator pumps, and all that kind of stuff. This whole top row, all the way down there, is all throttle and shift cables. So if you've got to shift your boat or break a cable, you should be able to call Englund Marine. We should have it in stock. We have 7 stores, 2 distribution outfits, so somewhere, some way, there's a cable to fit your boat.
This is like the mothership here, but then there's 6 other stores. They got one. Just name off real quick.
Starting north, we got Westport, Owaco, Astoria, Newport, Charleston, Crescent City, California, and Eureka, California.
Yeah. and this is where you supply all those stores from.
So we supply all those stores from here, and then U.S. Distributing out of Portland, we also own that.
Right.
So big fiberglass jobs. Exhaust wrap. Most people don't know what that is. It's rewettable exhaust wrap that goes over KO wool, which is the nastiest stuff in the world. But so the exhaust in your boat, that's what you wrap with to keep the heat down so it doesn't cook stuff. Marine hose, exhaust hose. This whole rack over here is full of hardwall and softwall exhaust holes. Bellas Flex, U.S. Coast Guard approved for fuel, exhaust, water, whatever you need on your boat. This is what the Coast Guard recommends to do that with. Full line of fuel hose up front. Stainless steel screen. You won't find that hardly any place else. No place else that I know of. And it generally is in 3 different sizes. This is the biggest, then it goes down in size from that. There you go.
I don't think I've ever seen stainless steel screen like that.
So, you think it was all for boats? Probably the most popular thing to sell that for is people go around their houses, plug up all their holes with it around their eaves and stuff to keep birds and stuff out because it doesn't rot out. Rats can't chew through it. It is the stuff.
I need some of that. Right.
Suction hose, sanitation hose. So those are all bait jars for commercial crabbing back there, commercial crab rope there. We also have another big warehouse out back full of commercial crab gear. Bungee cord. We probably have the largest amount of cordage anywhere. We've got bungee cord there, some other ropes there. Regular blue steel there. Ton of welding supplies just coming in, getting checked in there. We have big rope.
Yes, you did.
You know, if you're going through pilings or whatever, a lot of people, we don't sell any of this for actual marine use, but we have manila rope everywhere from inch and a half. The guys spliced a eye in just for fun there, but all the way down to 3/8. You want to wrap a piling at your house, string them along, make some kind of decorative thing, you can do all of that.
Yeah.
And out here's where the real fun starts.
Yeah.
The guys in our shop can build any kind of cable you want. We build chokers, we put cable on boats, we put cable on tow trucks, build straps for log trucks. These guys can build anything out of cable that you really need built. We keep actual chokers in stock most of the time. That's a little strap. But we build a suit. We have stainless cable, galvanized cable, regular black coiled cable. or anything you could possibly want.
Yeah.
Tie up line for big, big boats. We missed a couple of the bigger ones there. Again, our import blocks, that the snatch blocks, anywhere from a little 3-inch one you can carry in your backpack when you've got your chainsaw winch to pull your elk out, to a monster one that you can pull anything you want. We do a huge amount of spectra line. This is actually called Amsteel. That's stronger than cable, the same size. We splice it, build it for logging operations, boat operations. Actually do a huge amount in winch lines for ATVs, because it's small, it's light.
Yeah. So this is stronger than cable. So
that's stronger than cable, the same size.
Like,
if you fish with tough line or any Power Pro or whatever, this is a monster Power Pro.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Well, this is really something else back here. Yeah.
When you come to the store, you see that it's a big store, but you don't realize how big the whole thing is. And
you guys out here in the shop also build hydraulic lines. They can come back here in the hydraulic shop, which is actually really clean today. Build you any kind of a hydraulic hose for your tractor, your lawnmower. We don't do steering lines for cars, but tractors, boats, anything that runs on hydraulics, log splitters, you name it. These guys can come back and show them some parts. I'll put it together for you. It's pretty amazing, actually.
That's
several different hydraulic presses all over the place. New hydraulic hose coming in, workbenches.
A big workforce here, man. There's a lot of people working here.
Get together tomorrow, and I'm pit barreling a bunch of tri-tips for it. Yeah. I think we're figuring there's going to be 58 people.
Yeah.
Just employees, and so it's not counting spouses and everything else.
Right, and not just employees, but these people have to know what they're doing. I mean, these are real professionals
nothing you can't, that we have here, that you can't buy online, except some service and some knowledge. None of us know it all, but we have somebody that knows about all this stuff. How we stay alive. Batteries just came in. We stock a full line of batteries for your boat, car, or whatever. Stainless chain, can't get that everywhere. We have stainless chain. We actually bring that in ourselves. We have triple B, high test, and load rated chain. And just a ton of regular galvanized chain. So cut chain and do whatever you need here. This is one order for one customer. This is the bomb-proof room where you want to go if there's a really bad thing, except for it's all filled with welding gases. Oxygen, acetylene, everything from running your big welder to running your kegerator. We got gas for it back here. This is all just zip ties. And the rest of the aisle is just hardware along the way.
All right.
And belts. We have belts. We don't do very many automotive belts, but other than that, any kind of belt for your boat, we should have.
You could just literally build a boat from scratch here, huh?
You're pretty close. Everything but the motors.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mark. You know, but what I want you to do is explain to people that are coming down here, maybe to fish buoy 10 or just come drive through here up Highway 30. How do you tell them how to get here, right? You got the Astoria Megler Bridge
is right there. So here's buoy 10, but if you're driving
the
down,
Astoria boatyard's right there. You can see that from, like, when you come over the bridge, you can take that. So people pull their boats out and work on them right here, which is very convenient for us and them that we're right here. But probably the easiest way, if you're coming from south, as soon as you cross the Youngs Bay Bridge, you take the first left. If you're coming from the east, come just past Dutch Brothers and the pressure washing place and take a right.
Okay.
It's Hamburg Avenue.
Yeah, you know, because I drove by here, I don't know how many hundreds of times, and didn't even realize the store was here for a while. But it's right off of Highway 30, which is right there. So you go under the bridge. If you're coming from, say, Portland area, you're coming under the Astoria Megler Bridge. And right before you get to the traffic circle, the big traffic circle,
yep,
you just take a right, and it's right here. And it kind of makes sense, you know, maybe if you're not familiar with what we're talking about here, we're in Astoria, which is the mouth of the Columbia River, which is one of the biggest shipping and boating areas in the world.
Absolutely.
So it makes sense that there's a really cool store like this here. So that it's what it is. It matches the area. But if you're from out of the area and you're coming into town, just make a point to stop here and just look around. I think you'll really enjoy, you know, spending a little bit of time here.
It's pretty fun.
Yeah, it is.
To work out and to come shopping at.
It is a fun place.
And if you shop here every day and work here every day, it's really expensive some days.
Yeah, really. Yeah. You know, but if you're a fisherman or you're just in the boating or just like the sort of thing, you're going to like this shop.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Mark.
Thanks, Justin.